I am Joyce McDaniel Felder, your district mental health facilitator. First, I want to let you know that I have recorded this session from one of our schools in the school district. So right now throughout the session, we hope it don't happen, but hey, things happen. It's called life. So if you hear an alarm, a bell, some noise or some talking in the background, let's not be too distracted because like I said, I am at a school, but hopefully that doesn't happen. Okay, let's get started with the topic discussion for my PowerPoint presentation, emotional distress to emotional success. Okay, emotional distress is a negative emotional reaction, which may include fear, anger, anxiety, and suffering in students and adults. I have an exercise for you. We are all going to participate, hopefully, because I know who's signed up to have the session. So you will provide the feedback to me to my questions to my email, which is Joyce, J-O-Y-C-E dot Felder, F-E-L-D-E-R at OCSDSC.org. Again, Joyce.Felder at OCSDSC.org. Okay, so the first exercise is, tell me, what do you fear? Just write down one fear or send it in an email to me. You can either do them all one time and send it at the end of the presentation, or you can do it alone, whatever your preference. Two, what causes anger in you? Three, what causes anxiety in you? Again, what causes fear in you? What causes anger in you? And what causes anxiety in you? That's the first exercise. Just give me one for each. Okay, we're gonna move right along to goal. And we all know the definition of what a goal is, something you work or strive towards, right? So change the negative behavior into positive outcomes. Oops, let's go back. What are some negative behaviors? Just name one for me. A negative behavior for me is being late. It's negative. How do we make that even positive? Outcome. We prioritize, we plan. This is how it's going to become positive. You'll be on time or extra early. Okay, that's a question. It's an exercise question. Okay. All righty. We will move right along to warning signs of emotional distress. Warning signs: eating or sleeping too much. Example, ongoing consistent sleeping with no desire to do anything. Consumption of food without any regard for the quality or amount. That's a warning sign of emotional distress. Another, pulling away from people and things. Difficulties readjusting to home and work life. Example, distancing and withdrawing from others more frequently than others. Okay. Having no energy or low energy. Feeling drained or exhausted majority of the time. Okay, those are warning signs. Others include having unexplained aches and pains, such as constant headaches or stomach aches. Example, no explanation for ongoing medical conditions or concerns. There's no real reason, no explanation for it. Excessive smoking, drinking, or using drugs, including prescription medications. Overusing, abusing. Example, use of more than usual daily recommended amounts of any of these things. And last but not least, thinking of hurting or killing yourself or someone else. Example, thoughts are ongoing. If it's ongoing and consistent and outside of their normal thinking patterns, warning signs, okay? That person is having the thoughts, have a plan, they have means, and then they speak of how they are going to execute it, which means put it into motion. We must do something at that point, okay? So, for you guys, other than the ones that I've already named some warning signs, provide me with one additional warning signs of something that is, you know, distressful for you. Give you about a minute. Okay, now that we have discussed what emotional distress entails and provided examples, and you provided that exercise information to me, we will move right along to road to positive outcomes. Change negative thoughts into positive thoughts by scheduling meals and work breaks throughout the day for a balance in your daily life. I now tell folks when I do workshops, plan your breaks. Plan your own time out. Incorporate it, build it in your schedule. Sidebar, side note. I teach 3 classes back to back. I will take a 15 here or a 10 here. I will have some me time to diffuse my mind, clear it up before I start my next session. Next, spending family and friends time, enjoying each other and fellowshipping together. Well, we wish we can do that right now, but for the most part, we have to practice the COVID-19 safeguards we have in place, but you know, Teams and Zoom, social media, is 100% now for everybody. So we can still do it, just do it in a different manner. Listening to soothing music or reading a good book. And participating in yoga or other exercises that stimulate the mind and relaxes the body, such as walking and running. Now, your schedule may not permit for you to walk and run while at school, because some of you guys may have back-to-back classes. Some may have, what else you all have? Planning periods, but your planning period is usually where you have to get everything together and prepare. So you take out that 5 minutes, sit at your desk, walk around your class, close your eyes, throw your head back, throw your head down if you like. Close your eyes and go someplace other than where you're at in that moment that's peaceful and happy. Okay? Give me an example. Yes, I love examples for the exercises of a positive outcome or something negative that you can turn into something positive. Okay? Now, once you've done all the things that I've discussed, you would have mastered this presentation on emotional distress to your positive outcomes, okay? So with that said, here are some website you can go to for more information and additional information. Or you can contact me as well. I already gave the information, but it is on the PowerPoint for your view. I thank you so much for participating in the presentation. Now, the session evaluation of me. Please use a QR code to answer a few questions. It's only 10 simple questions about the session. Thank you for your feedback. And have a great day in Orangeburg County.